Hello, 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 my dear student. This week we will be covering two important topics in physics. Physics, fission and fusion. The objectives that we will be covering is to develop models of the process involved in nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Develop understanding that changes in binding energy within atomic nuclei. Explain the conversion of mass to energy in fission and fusion, and incorporate this understanding into models of the processes. Then we will make claims about the application of nuclear fission and fusion in producing energy that can be supported by evidence and reason. Now, first we will define what is nuclear reaction. Is a change of one or more atomic nuclei. That the energy released during nuclear reaction can take three forms: electromagnetic radiation, kinetic energy, and mass of particles. Mass is converted to electromagnetic radiation when an electron and positron collide. How does the energy of these two gamma rays compare to the masses of electron and positron? The combined energy of the two gamma rays is equal to the combined mass of the electron and positron. Now, we will explain how mass is converted to the kinetic energy of the resultant particle. Mass, momentum, and of course charge are conserved. Then we will talk about curve of binding energy. We will see that the binding energy is different for each nuclei. Then we will discuss nuclear fission. What is it? The splitting of a large atomic nuclei into smaller nuclei. Nucleus in which the binding of one extra neutron provides enough energy to cause the nucleus to split apart. Chain reaction is the neutrons released in fission reaction cause additional fission reactants. And then we will talk about power from nuclear fission. Reaction release a huge amount of energy but are non-renewable source of energy. Now, why are nuclear fission reactions non-renewable? I need you to answer this question. There are limited supplies on Earth of large nuclei such as uranium-235, and the nuclei don't exist anymore once they have broken apart. As you can see here, we'll talk about fission products, radioactive waste. The product of nuclear fission are typically unstable. Radiation from radioactive waste continues while the products of nuclear fission undergo multiple alpha, beta, and gamma decays until they become stable nuclei. We will discuss this and much more in our classes. What is the definition of nuclear fission? And that it occurs naturally in stars. And then we will compare energy transformation. I hope you will understand this lesson as you have